What's up? I was doing a little messing around with the GoPro, getting some videos out, and I totally forgot that I had a whole bunch of videos from a tuna fishing trip that I got to go on like 2 weeks back. It was pretty cool. It was my first time going offshore overnight for tuna. I've been booked on a bunch of tuna trips before, and I've never had the opportunity to get out. It's a very expensive hobby. It's also very time consuming, and there's a lot involved. But I'm blessed up. My buddy Joey T took out myself and a crew of four other awesome guys. And we had an awesome mate, AJ, with us, who worked his balls off to do the best he could to get us on some fish. And the captain did a great job. We just we didn't get into any big bluefin tuna, and that's what we were out there to get. We didn't have a lot of intel to go on because the weather had been crappy for like a week prior, and there wasn't a lot of boats out. And we ran out to the Wilmington Canyon and tried our best, and we were on the troll and we were on the chunk. But before we started tuna fishing, we got into some awesome mahi fishing, and what a cool experience it was to have that. It's the first time I ever got to do that, and it's very similar to reef fishing. And I got to do some reef fishing down in the Florida Keys this past January, and it's a cool game, and you need good visibility, and you have to be able to see the fish and see the bait and see them coming. And we had multiple hookups. We had runoffs. We had fish to the boat. We lost a lot of fish, put a couple on too. But we didn't fish it for a really long time because we were excited to get out and try to catch some of these tuna, but we had a blast. The whole trip was a blast. And I don't know, we got jammed up a little bit too. Right during the magic hour, the good fine men and women of the United States Coast Guard, God bless them, but they decided to board our vessel 110 miles offshore. They had a big like 280-foot cutter out there, and they radioed over and said they were coming aboard for a safety check. And you can't blame them for doing their jobs, and we didn't give them a hard time or anything like that. And they treat us with the utmost respect, but they checked everything they were supposed to. They checked the EPIRB, the life raft, the life preservers, you know, just all that good stuff, all the captain's paperwork, and that tied us up for a while. And by the time we got back fishing ready, it was time to get a couple hours shut-eye. We woke up in the morning, and we went out and took a long run to some grounds where there were about 40 to 50 other boats out there. And there was not a good bite that day. Nobody was really doing much. I think there might have been one or two fish caught. We didn't get the giant bluefin tuna we were looking for, but I did get the opportunity to have an awesome experience out there on the water. Every chance I get to get out on the water and experience something new is just, for me, it's a step in the right direction, right? It brings me closer to the powers that be, and I say this all the time, right? There's something really powerful out there that makes the ocean currents move around and makes the fish move and makes the tides change and the sun come up every morning and every night. And on this particular trip, I got to see a beautiful canyon sunset. I got to see a moonrise. I got to see a sunrise the next morning, all in the same shift. So here's a little bit of our tuna fishing trip. Mahi catching. Enjoy. Squid chunks. See if we can get some mahi. 600 feet deep, but the fish will be right up on top. So AJ gonna throw a couple pieces out. Brian's on the rod. See if we can get one to pull.
The best, so put me to the test, and I'm sure you'll soon agree that I got no flaws, cause I'm down by law when it comes to rocking viciously, you see, cause of when I was a little baby boy, my mama gave me a brand new toy, two turntables with a mic, and I learned to rock like a Dolomite. Time went by on this God creation, I knew someday I would rock the nation, so I made up my mind just what to do, and I joined with the Gem on production crew, so go crazy, don't let your body be lazy, I said don't stop the body rock till your eyesight starts to get hazy, to the sure shot, choose it to the bone, call the chili beans on the microphone, to your mind is broken like you're in a dream, and you feel so good that you gotta scream, Gem on it, a Gem on it, and on and on and on. Everybody going, and that doesn't happen to the break of dawn. Clean out your ears and you open your eye. If you want to hear the music, just come alive. If you don't know how, get ready to learn. Those guys won't think it's his turn to burn. Take a
seat and open. Fish on, fish on. Fish on, times two. This goes for a long time. That's me. That boat's so sweet. It's great. Can you rock it? Hey, don't really get the track. Don't really get the track. Yeah, they're both around the marker. Both over the buoy. Just get the gap ready, sacrifice the lines, put the fish in the boat. You want a long handle gap?
I like it too. swordfish rigs on there. Got some whole squid, got some weights to keep them down, some balloons to keep them up. Kind of floating around. We got the lights going on the back of the boat. Green lights going, reflects the water. Try to drum a couple squid up. It's been pretty quiet thus far. The rest of the crew is all crashed out. Captain and his mate are getting some shut eye, and I'm headed up to the bridge every 15-20 minutes or so. Check the screen, pan it out, make sure there's no other boats around us. My instructions are, you know, if there is a boat around us and we're on a crash course, it'll turn red. The blue blip will turn red, and then I gotta go wake the captain up. I don't want to have to do that, but I don't know, it's pretty cool. It's pretty calm and peaceful out here. The moon has finally come up. You're probably not going to be able to see it in the low level light, but that little blip out there in the distance, that is the moon. There's not a lot of moonlight. There's a couple other boats out. You can see some lights off. There's Mr. Ryan just waking up from his little nap up on the bridge. He's been hanging with me, hanging strong, and gonna ride us out for another, although I think 3:30, 4 o'clock, they're getting up, and we got all the chunks ready to go, and all our baits ready, all our lines are prepped, all our rods are prepped for the morning, and see if we can't get into some big bluefin. We were able to put one awesome mahi in the cooler today. We had a couple other ones hooked up. We were playing around with them, and we converted over to control them pretty quickly, and stay on the mahi bite, try to get into some of the bigger fish. Can always play with them again tomorrow, so